tonight from Kenosha, game two of this four-game series as the Rivets take on the defending Northwoods League champion, Kenosha Kingfish. Good evening, everybody, from Simmons Field in Kenosha. B.J. Walters with you. Last night, a 2-1 win for the Rivets in game one of this four-game split series. Tonight, Andrew Reisinger, a right-hander, will take the ball for Kenosha. He will be matched by right-hander Cole Belair. It's a beautiful night for baseball, and we'll have the full lineups coming up for you shortly. But when we come back, a full pregame. We'll talk to the voice of the Kingfish, Robert Sherman, shortly. But first, we will talk on the other side of this break to Big Country, who made his debut last night, and it was impressive. Tyler Thornton coming up. This is Rivets Baseball.
Join us at Rivets Stadium June 24th for a 6:35 p.m. first pitch against Wisconsin Rapids. Get to the ballpark early to see a human cannonball enter the stadium during the pregame. It's also the first night of a four-night Cheap Trick bobblehead series. Check out the awesome bobbleheads and enjoy a night out at the ballpark by calling 815-240-4159 or visiting rockfordrivets.com for tickets today.
Join us for the first fireworks night of the year on Saturday night, June 11th at 6:35 when the Rivets face the defending NWL champion Kenosha Kingfish. Enjoy a great night of baseball and cap it off with a spectacular fireworks show after the game. To get your tickets for fireworks night, go to rockfordrivets.com or call 815-240-4159.
Back on the pregame show in Kenosha, let's visit with the Rivets player tonight. It is Big Country, Tyler Thornton. Tyler, let's start there. How'd you get that nickname, or did Ferg just create this without you being here?
Well, the guy said he was calling me that before I got here, so I guess it stuck. They asked me if I had any nicknames. I was like, well, call me Big Country, so I guess I'll stick with it.
Not bad, not bad. What have the last 48 hours been like for you? You get to Rockford, meet your host family, get the first save in the franchise's history. It must be going a million miles an hour for you.
Yeah, it's fun. Woke up at 4 yesterday. You know, I didn't really expect to pitch the first day, but I got the call down to the bullpen, and I was ready to go.
Was it different coming into the clubhouse and meeting all of these new guys? And how many of them did you previously speak to, and how many of them did you maybe know already?
It's definitely different. Didn't know any of the guys on the team before. Meeting new guys is always fun. Always being on a new team of guys, getting to meet new players from all over the country. You know, it's just enjoyable, and I'm glad to be here.
The reason you're late getting here, you played in a little thing called a World Series, not so bad, for Tennessee Wesleyan. What was the season like? How much fun and how special was it to get to a World Series?
It was our first World Series appearance since 2012. We had a new coach this year, so being able to make it in his first year is a pretty big accomplishment in my eyes. It was a really fun experience. Just being able to go to a World Series in front of 7,000 fans, really eye-opening, and really had a great time.
And so you've obviously had a lot of games this spring. Coming into the summer, what are your goals? What do you want to really focus on and get better at throughout this entire season?
This summer season, I'd like to get some pro interest. I know playing in the Northwoods League, it's a very high scouted league. I know it's very very high up in college baseball, and you know, just work on getting in better shape and getting ready for next year.
What was the reaction that you had the first time you talked to Brian about coming to the Rockford Rivets?
I was very excited. You know, new team, he said it would be a fun experience, new stadium, so I was all for it.
What did you know previously about the league as a whole, other than, yeah, it's really good for future pros?
Not much, honestly, about the league. Besides, I know it's highly scouted, and I'd seen, you know, current big leaguers have played in this league. So I know, wow, what an opportunity to come and try and get seen. So I was all for it.
Now back to last night.
You wowed a lot of people in the stadium. Was your adrenaline really pumping, or is that just big country on a daily basis right there?
I felt pretty calm out there, you know. I've always thrown hard all my life, and I was just out there doing my thing.
Have you ever wondered what it would be like to face yourself as a hitter?
I've honestly thought about that a lot, and I think I would struggle, because in high school I was a pretty good hitter, and just knowing my ability was pitching, I think I would struggle.
The one pitch that you threw that probably got ignored a little bit because of the fastballs, that slider, That's a problem for a hitter, isn't it? Because they have to get geared up for your fastball.
Yeah, I usually try to throw a lot of fastballs, trying to get them to gear up on the fastball, and then I can break a slider off at any count and just get them to look pretty silly.
As a pitcher, when you do that, when you get a hitter to look silly, such as the final pitch last night, what does it make a pitcher feel like? Like, what are the emotions from the mound when you see a guy look a little silly up there?
Well, it gives you a ton of confidence knowing that your pitches are dirty, and just being able to, you know, get strikeouts and make hitters look dumb. It's just a great feeling.
Last question for you. We're visiting with Tyler Thornton on the pregame. Night in Rockford. I'm sure if you wanted to go out and have a steak dinner, someone would have bought it for you after that performance. Did you get a lot of people saying, wow, that was really impressive? And if so, how cool is it to go into a new place and be able to show a new fan base what you could do?
I had some people come after the games. They were impressed with what they saw. And, just being able to come to a new team and showing them what I got, coming from a smaller school, just shows you that the talent's there. Just about where you get recruited to, and being able to come here and perform the first night is all I could ask for.
Tyler, continued success.
Thank you.
Tyler Thornton, our guest. When we get back, we will have a sit down with the voice of the defending champion Kingfish, Robert Sherman. We'll do that right after this. This is Rivets Baseball.
Make plans to join us at Rivets Stadium every Friday home game after that long week of work for TGIF night at Rivets Stadium. You can get $3 beer specials from the time gates open until first pitch is delivered. So kick back and enjoy some Rivets baseball with a cold beer in hand. Our next TGIF night is June 24th versus the Wisconsin Rapids Raptors. Call 815-240-4159 or visit rockfordrivets.com for tickets today.
Back on the pregame show at Simmons Field in Kenosha, and usually we like to feature one of the coaches, but we're giving them a down day as they give their pitchers during this summer. Let's talk to the voice of the defending champion Kingfish, Robert Sherman. And Robert, it's 9 games already. I was talking to the office staff this morning and I said, there's no way. We're an eighth of the way through this. Wow, it flies by, doesn't it?
Oh, it absolutely does, and I just remember this from last year, that it takes so long for the season to get started, and you so anticipate opening day coming around here, and then opening day comes, and the second day comes, and all of a sudden you look back and you realize we've already played 8, 9, 10 games. We're already a week and a half into the year, and, I mean, you break things down. There's only 72 games in the regular season, so, I mean, it's incredible with the way that time really does fly in this league, and very quickly, it's going to be through the month of June, and then even quicker, the All-Star game, and then even more quick, all the way to the final game of the season. It's unbelievable.
More on last year's title team in a second, but you are in your second year as voice of the Kingfish. Do you see anything as far as a trend goes this year, last year, early in the season, or are there just no comparisons to be made and you throw them out the window?
In general, when you take a look at the season, I think that things happen in a similar way as we were just talking about time a moment ago. Things start really slow, then quickly pick up pace, and I think you also see that on the field translate as well. For some players, you'll see a lot of guys that have just an inability to find any success throughout the first week or two of the season, and then you're going to have another group of guys on the other side of the coin that inexplicably are just astounding through the first couple of weeks and are really out there finding a lot of success, whether they're at the plate or on the mound, and oftentimes either those guys are going to ride out that success throughout the entire year, or you're going to see a nice little dip down probably midway to late through June and start to, I guess, retract towards a little bit more so of what you would expect of their playing ability over the course of an entire season. Those are the only real trends that I think that, I mean, I was able to notice last year and I'm starting to pick up on this year. I mean, the other thing too is it's just so many new faces that just so par for the course with a lot of programs that, the Kingfish, for example, they're bringing back, I think, 8 players from last year's title team, and that's probably in the 90, 95th percentile in the league. A lot of new faces year in and year out.
And then the postseason, and what was it like to see a title-winning team put together?
I'll tell you, it was honestly the summer of my life, without a doubt. But it was one of those things that, I mean, coming here to the ballpark every day and looking up in the booth and down on the field, and you just see this team keep on winning, you say, all right, when's this going to stop? When are they streak a little bit? And they never really did. There was a period in the first half of the year where things started to not go the team's way, and you just thought to yourself, all right, here it is. This is the bulk that we were really expecting. I think they lost 8 straight games and was finally saw that come down to earth moment, but all of a sudden the team picked right back up again and was hotter than they were even in the first half of the year. And I mean, we were talking just a moment ago about a whole bunch of different players being waived, released, and having to say goodbye to. That was a big storyline from last year's ball club. We went through so many different players, many more so than the other team that we played in the championship, the St. Cloud Rocks. I think they went through 44 players, and I think we went through upwards of 62, 63. So we went through quite a few players last year, and that was one of the reasons that so many people thought there's no way that this is going to be able to sustain itself. But new talent kept coming in, new faces kept showing up at the ballpark, and all these guys started to contribute, and the chemistry just seemed to click naturally. It was really unbelievable to see. It was inexplicable with the way that the team was able to overcome all these hurdles and still find success, but I'll tell you, PJ, it was a lot of fun to watch, and it was an honor to be on the call for the first ever Kenosha Kingfish franchise title season, and I mean, it was a big part of the reason I wanted to come back this year. It was just a summer to remember.
And any title-winning team needs a little luck, and it just so happens that it came completely unexpected for you guys late in the first half last year.
Yeah, that was a little bit of an interesting story as well. We were talking about how the team started off hot, then it hit that 8-game losing streak or so, and that's when things weren't looking very good, and we were actually tied with Green Bay going into the last day of the first half title, and the team that wins the first half title gets an automatic bid for home field advantage in the first round of the playoffs, and Green Bay had the tiebreaker over us, and so no matter what we did, if Green Bay won that day, Green Bay was going to get the nod. And Green Bay was winning, I remember this, and then all of a sudden, going through the schedules, this was Duffy Dyer, this was the ever-meticulous Duffy Dyer, our manager, went through the schedules and found out that a loss was not calculated into Green Bay's overall record, and when contacting the league and they went through everything, they found out that was exactly right. So a loss was added, and the Kingfish, all of a sudden, lo and behold, had a half-game advantage on the final day of the first half of the season, and they were able to win that game over the Lakeshore Chinooks later in the evening, and they took the first half title, and it was in that moment that you kind of realized there's something special right now, because it just seems as though that it's meant to be. And again, I keep using the word inexplicable, but everything clicked into place when it probably shouldn't have, but it just plain and simply did.
Last thing before we let you go, you've got a broadcast to prep for as well. Rockford, new franchise, they've never seen Northwoods League baseball in the town. Can you give the fan base a taste of what this league is all about and how great it really is for these guys who will probably play professionally someday?
You know, it's actually really funny because when I was first looking at broadcasting gigs, I had never heard of summer collegiate baseball, and then ended up working in this league last year as a broadcaster for a team. But it's such a unique little experience because, I mean, the best way to describe it is these are the best of the best, the most elite of all baseball players in college. I mean, some of these kids who come from all different parts of the country, whether they're from UCLA, whether they're from the University of Florida, whether they're the University of Michigan, I mean, any one of these top-notch programs, it's so neat to just see this melting pot of different personalities and different backgrounds for guys come together on a ball club and play baseball. But then what's even more fun to see is towns like Kenosha, towns like Madison, towns like La Crosse that not only come out to the games, but just get fully behind the team in full force, become the biggest of supporters and fans of some of these ball clubs. I remember that I was talking to John Papadopoulos, who's the voice of the La Crosse Loggers, and they had Mason McCoy, who was the league MVP last year. And Mason McCoy, last game of the regular season, he's announced over the PA, he's coming up to bat, and the entire stadium erupts chanting MVP, MVP. And that was just a moment when I heard this story, I just thought, that's awesome. These people that are in these towns and get to come out to these ballparks, they care. They love the kids, they love the ballparks, they love the ball clubs, and they love being supportive of all these programs. I mean, you'll get to see tonight, BJ, and get a taste of what Kenosha baseball is all about, but these are fans that will show up a half hour, an hour before the first pitch, and they'll stay right to the very end, whether the team is winning by one in a tight pitcher's duel or whether they're losing by nine. These fans come out, they're passionate. It's a lot of fun to watch, and it's a great family experience. That's why I've loved working in the league.
Robert, continued success with the Kingfish, and thanks for doing this.
BJ, I really appreciate it, and good luck tonight.
Robert Sherman, the voice of the Kenosha Kingfish. When we come back, it's the lineups and the first pitch. That one, Rivets Baseball, continues in a moment.
Join us Wednesday, June 29th at 11 a.m. as the Rivets take on the Madison Mallards for Kids Day at the ballpark. Your $10 ticket includes a voucher for a hot dog, soda, and a bag of chips. What better way to spend a sunny summer day than your child falling in love with the game of baseball? Enjoy Kids Day on June 29th out at the ballpark by calling 815-240-4159 or visiting rockfordrivets.com for tickets today.
Back in Kenosha, just about ready to go here, the Kingfish and the Rockford Rivets. The Rivets lineup has been turned in by Brian Smith. It looks like this, leading off the left fielder Josh Hauser, batting second and center Jacob Vanderwall, batting third at short Alex Maloney. Batting fourth is the first baseman, Ricardo Ramirez. Batting fifth and right, Corey Wright. Batting sixth, the designated hitter, Neil Tyrell. Batting seventh and third is Cade Bunnell. Batting eighth, the catcher, Braden Williams. And batting ninth is the second baseman, David Cronin. That all in support of Cole Belair tonight. The Kingfish line up like this. Matt Hearn is the second baseman he leads off. Batting second at third is Kian O'Brien. Batting third at first is Cal Jadaki. Batting eighth in center is Nick Canavas. Batting fifth is the catcher, Pete Schuler. Batting sixth, the designated hitter, Mason Fishback. Batting seventh is the right fielder, Wes Weeks. Batting eighth in left is Jack Yellowitz. And batting ninth is the shortstop, Colin Josowak. That in support of Andrew Reisinger. Reisinger is making his second appearance of the season for the Kingfish. He has no record, two innings pitched, one hit, one strikeout. It was in relief. We're just about ready to go. It will be Josh Hauser. Hauser from the right side, he's become accustomed to that leadoff spot over the last few games, and he's hit well in it. In fact, Hauser up to 214, 6-for-28. He was down beneath 100 before the move. The first pitch of the ball game is a strike, and we are underway at 7:06. It is 70 degrees at game time. 0-1. The right-hander Reisinger brings it. It's a little bit wide. Our home plate umpire tonight, Jeff Heyman. Cole Lockhart at first. Kurt Arkenberg is at third. One ball and one strike. The pitch is away, 2-1. It's 3:14 to left, 3:30 to right, and about 390 to center, maybe more. The pitch is high, 3-1. We don't actually have a marker in center field. This is a very
old school ballpark, and it's got a very new school feel to it. Here's the 3-1. It's outside, a leadoff walk for Josh Hauser. And Jacob Vanderwall will hit. Vanderwall is the club's leading hitter. Comes in. He comes in on the year, hitting 296. That leads the club. So does his five runs scored, his triple, and five RBI, second on the team. If you're wondering about Hauser, he's 1-for-2, and the pitch is low. It's 1-0. Hauser aboard at first. Nobody out. We're just underway tonight in Kenosha, Wisconsin. Big hole on the right side. The set and the pitch. A swing and a ground ball to second. The flip by Hearn to Josewak for one. The relay back to Jadaki, not in time. It's a fielder's choice for 6, and there's one down. So Vanderwall aboard on the force out of Hauser. And with one down, it will bring up Alex Maloney. And now Duffy Dyer is going to talk to the base umpire, Kurt Arkenberg, rather. What he wants, perhaps, is interference on Hauser. Not sure that he'll get it. We'll see. The defense left to right in the outfield for the Kingfish is Jack Yalowitz, Nick Canavas, and Wes Weeks. Left side of the infield, Kean O'Brien and Colin Josewak. Right side, Matt Hearn and Cal Jadaki, with Pete Schuler catching the right-hander, Andrew Reisinger. So here's Maloney, the Ball State product from Chelsea, Michigan. Righty-righty matchup, runner at first, one out. Top of the first, the stretch. And from the first base side, Reisinger throws a strike. It's 0-1. It's a really nice night for a ball game here in Kenosha. Maloney, a 267 hitter, also with five runs scored. The 0-1 is a strike over the outside edge, and it's 0-2. Maloney way behind 0-2. The stretch, the check of Vanderwall at first, and the pitch outside 1-2. A ball and two strikes. Game's well underway in the Northwoods League. We'll keep you updated throughout the evening. This is one of 10 games tonight with a doubleheader being played. Here comes a 1-2. Vanderwall almost got picked off. He took a step towards second, had to dive back to first. He did so. Vanderwall last night was picked off when his foot slipped off first base. Tyrell was also picked off last night. The stretch by Reisinger, small lead Vanderwall, and he takes one step to get back of ahead of a pickoff throw. Vanderwall is tied for the club lead in steals with 4 so far. He and Ricardo Ramirez tied in that category. Reisinger ready. The pitch. That's strike 3 called. And there's 2 down for Ricardo Ramirez. Ramirez has been playing quite well for the Rivets. Comes in as a 290 hitter with a club high 9 hits. doubles, a club-high 7 knocked in, and tied for a club-high with 5 runs. The Illinois-Chicago first baseman, 6'2 and 205 from Chicago originally, will face the righty Reisinger. Vanderwall a bigger lead at first. And a check throw, and back easily is Vanderwall. Vanderwall has his lead. Reisinger has his sign. He stretches and throws, and it's a strike 0-1. Reisinger really attacking the Rivets with his fastball early. This is a Rockford ball club that leads the league in strikeouts. Not something you want to be leading the league in. Overall, they hit 216, but on the road, just 184. Here's the 0-1. Fastball wide, 1-1. That 184 batting average on the road is a big reason why the Rivets are still searching for their first road win in franchise history. They're 0-4. 3-2 at home, but the struggles on the road see them with a 3-6 record. Kenosha 4-5, they've lost 4 straight. Vanderwall, a big lead, not going, down and away off speed, 2-1. 2 balls and a strike. There are several cool things here at Simmons Field for people to do. The bounce land down the right field line, another inflatable down the right field line. Nice park, too. Here's a 2-1. Slider over the inside edge. It's 2-2. Ramirez in a 2-2 count. Two and two the count. Vanderwall gets a reasonably sized lead. The pitch. We'll have to wait. Vanderwall's picked off. 1-3-6. Inning over. So Vanderwall gets picked off, and the Rivets do not score in the first. Here come the Kingfish against Cole Belair when we come back in just a moment.
Make plans to join us at Rivet Stadium every Thursday home game for Thirsty Thursday at 6:35. You can get $2 beer specials in the right field porch. So kick back and enjoy some baseball with a cold beer in hand. Our next Thirsty Thursday is June 23rd versus the Wisconsin Rapids Raptors. So call 815-240-4159 or visit rockfordrivets.com for tickets today.
Join us June 10th for Envelope Night at Rivets Stadium. The first 500 fans will receive a mystery envelope with the contents inside unknown until later in the game. You could win one of several prizes, from tickets to cold hard cash. You don't want to miss it. June 10th at 6:35 against Kenosha. Make plans to be at Rivets Stadium and get your prize.
Cole Belair takes the hill for the Rivets. He's 0-1 with an ERA of 7.20. In 5 innings, he gave up 6 hits, 5 runs, 4 earned, 1 walk, and 6 strikeouts. That came Friday night against Madison in the 8-3 loss to the Mallards. His defense, left to right in the outfield, is Josh Hauser, Jacob Vanderwall, and Corey Wright. Third to first on the infield, Cade Bunnell, Alex Maloney, David Cronin, and Ricardo Ramirez, with Braden Williams catching the right-hander from the University of Illinois, Cole Belair. 6'1", 205 from Lockport. He's wearing number 31 tonight, his usual number, number 12, unavailable to him this evening. Here comes Matt Hearn. Hearn in the league leaders for batting average coming into last night. He's dropped out of the top 10 for now, but he's still off to a good start this year. He's hitting 370 to lead their club, 10 for 27, with three runs scored. The first pitch, a strike. This is a Kingfish club hitting 213, a little bit better at home as you'd expect, 246. Here's the 0-1, showed bunt, took a ball. It's 1-1. One ball and one strike the count. Belair works from the third base side and he throws strike two. It's 1-2. Belair tonight is going to face a teammate in Jack Yalowitz later on in the lineup. Here's the 1-2. Slider, he struck him out swinging. Belair gets his first punch out and there's one away. And here's Kean O'Brien. O'Brien also off to a really nice start for the Kingfish. He's hitting 324, 11 for 34. He takes a strike, it's 0-1. Enough at bats now up and down the league, the pitch low, 1-1, to be able to notice some trends. And the trend with the Kingfish is the top of their order is very good. They're still waiting on the bottom of the order to catch up. The 1-1 is a strike and it's 1-2. One ball, two strikes. Quickly, Belair to the plate, low, 2-2. We saw this Friday. Belair was on fire through three innings. And when he's feeling good, he works extremely quickly. 2-2 the count. The righty has his sign and brings it home. Swung on, grounded down to third. Nice scoop by Bunnell, but he throws it away. It's an E5 all the way. And a one-out base runner. Here's Cal Jadacki. Jadacki, 6'1", 185 from St. Joe's. And the Hawk comes in 1 for 15 on the season. The one hit was a double. First pitch, runner holds, fouled away 0-1. Jadacki was not in there last night. Gunnar McNeil played first an evening ago. 0-1. O'Brien at first and one man out. The stretch and the pitch. Swung on, popped up towards center. It's Jacob Vanderwall all the way into left center to make the catch. And there's two away. Here comes Nick Canavas. And Canavas last night was very good. He was 3 for 3 with two doubles and a single. The rest of the Kingfish had just four hits, but Canavas was swinging a very hot bat, and he takes a strike here. It's 0-1. Last night, a 2-hour, 12-minute game. A 2-1 Rockford win. 0-1 the count. The pitch, the runner goes. It's fouled away, 0-2. Oh and two is the count. Third baseman Bunnell had played in against Jadacki. He's back to normal depth. The outfield is shallow. Belair brings home an 0-2. High, 1-2, pickoff throw to first. Back is O'Brien. And it's 1-2. This is the second of a four-game series, the only game of the series here in Kenosha. A swing and a miss, strike three. Braden Williams will have to throw to first. He does, and the inning's over. No runs, no hits, an error and a man left. We go to the second. It's still scoreless.
After the nine-month grind of teaching the entire school year, those poor souls need a getaway. Well, fear not, because baseball is the answer. Join us Friday and Saturday night, June 10th and 11th at 6:35 for Teachers Appreciation Weekend at Rivets Stadium as Rockford hosts the defending Northwoods League champion Kenosha Kingfish for a two-game series. Get an infield reserve seat for the standard $10 and receive a complimentary drink, or purchase a standard price right field porch seat for $25 and get two complimentary drinks. Right field porch seats include all-you-can-eat hot dogs, brats, burgers, chips, soda, and water from the time gates open until 2 hours after first pitch. You can find nightly drink specials out on the right field porch as well. So make plans to join us June 10th and 11th for Teachers Appreciation Weekend at Rivets Stadium. Join us at Rivets Stadium June 24th for a 6:35 p.m. first pitch against Wisconsin Rapids. Get to the ballpark early to see a human cannonball enter the stadium during the pregame. It's also the first night of a four-night Cheap Trick bobblehead series. Check out the awesome bobbleheads and enjoy a night out at the ballpark by calling 815-240-4159 or visiting rockfordrivets.com for tickets today. After the nine-month grind of teaching the entire school year,
join us for the first fireworks night of the year on Saturday night, 11th at 6:35, when the Rivets face the defending NWL champion Kenosha Kingfish. Enjoy a great night of baseball and cap it off with a spectacular fireworks show after the game. To get your tickets for fireworks night, go to rockfordrivets.com or call 815-240-4159.
Ricardo Ramirez was hitting when Jacob Vanderwall was picked off, so he'll lead off the second inning. Ricardo is tied for the league lead in walks with 9. And the first baseman for the Rivets will step in there against the right-hander Andrew Reisinger, who had a strikeout also in that first inning. He works the extreme first base side of the mound, and he brings home the first pitch to Ramirez, who pops it up. It is headed towards the seats, and it is out of play. It's 0-1. It bears mentioning pop-ups tonight. The light stands are angled a bit differently. We mentioned how this is an old ballpark. Anything with reasonable depth could be interesting for anyone who has not played this ballpark before. 0-1 the count. Reisinger rocks, kicks, and fires. It's swung on and fouled straight back, 0-2. Corey Wright and Neil Tyrell to follow Ramirez in this second inning. We're scoreless in Kenosha tonight. 0-2 the count. And Reisinger rocks and brings it outside, 1-2. Ramirez had a 2-2 count on him in the first inning. When Vanderwall was picked. Here's the 1-2 that's inside. It's 2 balls and 2 strikes. It is almost a sellout here in Kenosha. Very close. It actually may be a sellout. The 2-2 is strike three called. Consecutive strikeouts wrapped around the pickoff for Reisinger. And with one out, it's Corey Wright. Wright comes in, hitting .273, 6-for-22 with 3 runs scored, 2 doubles and 2 knocked in. The right fielder for the Rivets takes strike one. It's 0-1. The Rivets have about another week to designate Corey Wright on the official roster to one position. He's played third, he's played the outfield, he's pitched. We'll see what Smitty decides to do. The pitch low, one ball, one strike. Brian Smith coaching third, Joshua Keim over at first. We're in the second, there's no score. Reisinger brings it home. A fastball over the inside edge, it's 1-2. Corey Wright was backing up off the plate, but it was poured in for a strike. One and two the count. Reisinger ready. Has his sign and fires it home. It's swung on and hit on the ground to the second baseman, Hearn. His throw to first is in time, two down. It'll bring up Neil Tyrell. Tyrell, a 257 hitter, leads the club in hits with nine. He's 9 for 35, 4 runs scored, 2 doubles. And 5 knocked in. Rivets nothing, Kenosha nothing in the second. The pitch is a strike, it's 0-1. Tyrell kind of shakes his head as if to say, no, man. But it hit the corner, according to Jeff Heyman, our home plate umpire. The 0-1 is wide, and it's a ball and a strike. 1-1. It's a fine night for baseball in Kenosha tonight. And here's the 1-1. A swing and a ground ball to Joswak. He's going to throw high to first, but coming down with it and putting the tag on is Cal Jadocki. And it is a 1-2-3 inning for Andrew Reisinger. We're through an inning and a half, no score.
Make plans to join us at Rivet Stadium every Friday home game after that long week of work for TGIF night at Rivet Stadium. You can get $3 beer specials from the time gates open until first pitch is delivered. So kick back and enjoy some Rivets baseball with a cold beer in hand. Our next TGIF night is June 24th versus the Wisconsin Rapids Raptors. Call 815-240-4159 or visit rockfordrivets.com for tickets today.
Join us Wednesday, June 29th at 11 a.m. as the Rivets take on the Madison Mallards for Kids Day at the ballpark. Your $10 ticket includes a voucher for a hot dog, soda, and a bag of chips. What better way to spend a sunny summer day than your child falling in love with the game of baseball? Enjoy Kids Day on June 29th out at the ballpark by calling 815-240-4159 or visiting rockfordrivets.com for tickets today.
Make plans to join us at Rivet Stadium every Thursday home game for Thirsty Thursday at 6:35. You can get $2 beer specials in the right field porch. So kick back and enjoy some baseball with a cold beer in hand. Our next Thirsty Thursday is June 23rd versus the Wisconsin Rapids Raptors. So call 815-240-4159 or visit rockfordrivets.com for tickets today.
In Kenosha, no score as we go to the last of the second inning. Cole Belair is going to face the 5-6-7 hitters, Schuler, Fishback, and Weeks in the second. Only two base runners have been an error against the Rivets, and a walk to Josh Hauser to start the ball game. Last night was 2-1 so far, well pitched tonight. Granted, a smaller sample size. Here comes Pete Schuler. Schuler comes in 7 for 23 with 4 runs scored, and he's got the only 2 home runs for the Kingfish. Also a club-high 5 RBI. First pitch is high, 1-0. Schuler, a tall individual, I should say. 6'3", 180 from right here in Kenosha. He goes to Kent State, the 1-0. Fastball, a strike, it's 1-1. And it's a ball and a strike. Braden Williams is back there catching during BP yesterday. Smitty had made mention that maybe he'd be down today. Sounds like Williams talked himself back into the lineup. The 1-1 is high, 2-1. Got a great hitting lesson earlier from Joshua Kime. We'll talk about that in the third. The 2-1 is ripped foul down the right side. It's 2-2. Now, I'm not saying I could go get a hit after talking to Keimer earlier, because I'm the least athletic person you've ever seen. But certainly helped to understand these guys' struggles. The 2-2 is swung on and hit in the air to right. Corey Wright going back near the warning track. It's off the base of the wall. And into second with the leadoff double is Pete Schuler. He didn't miss his third home run by much. And the first hit of the game belongs to the Kingfish. Here comes Mason Fishback. Fishback will hit right. Comes in, does Fishback. Hitting 429 in two games, he's 3-for-7. He does not qualify to be in the top 10 in batting at the moment, but if he did, he would rank number 6 in the league. Schuler at second, nobody out from the stretch. Belair fires outside 1-0. One ball and no strikes. One and oh the count. The pitch swung on and hit in the air to right. Corey Wright coming on, he's got it. And no movement at all by Pete Schuler. There's one down. Wright, it looked like, had that split second where he lost it. He quickly regained it, and there's one down. Here's Wes Weeks. Weeks so far on the campaign is 3-for-28. This is a club that, with that flyout, Kenosha, first pitch outside 1-0. Kenosha hitting 8-for-79 with runners in scoring position on the season. The Rivets know all about that. They are not much better. Here's the 1-0. A fastball strike, 1-1. The Rivets with runners in scoring position are 177. There's not a lot of difference there. 1-1 the count. Belair ready from the third base side of the mound. Brings it home, a fly ball on the infield. Going out Maloney. He calls it for it and makes the play. Two down. And here comes Jack Yalowitz. A 5'11", 185-pound freshman from the University of Illinois will face a 6'1", 205-pound freshman from the University of Illinois. Teammates here. You wonder if this has ever happened maybe in the preseason. Belair to Yellowitz, the pitch. A strike, it's 0-1. And surely they've bet something on this matchup, whether it be a soda, a meal, a baseball card, something. 0-1 the count. Belair against his Fighting Illini teammate, and time is called. Owen won the count, Belair set. Here's the pitch. Swung on, fouled off 0-2. Leadoff double by Schuler, then a fly out to right and a pop out to short. Oh and two is the count. long pause. Now Belair stretches and fires. Fastball, he struck him out swinging and the inning is over. No runs a hit, no errors and a man left, and we go to the third with the score. The Rivets nothing, Kenosha nothing.
Join us June 10th for Mystery Envelope Night at Rivets Stadium. The first 500 fans will receive a mystery envelope with the contents inside unknown until later in the game. You could win one of several prizes, from tickets to cold, hard cash. You don't want to miss it. June 10th at 6:35 against Kenosha. Make plans to be at Rivets Stadium and get your prize.
After the 9-month grind of teaching the entire school year, those poor souls need a getaway. Well, fear not, because baseball is the answer. Join us Friday and Saturday night, June 10th and 11th at 6:35 for Teachers Appreciation Weekend at Rivets Stadium as Rockford hosts the defending Northwoods League champion Kenosha Kingfish for a two-game series. Get an infield reserve seat for the standard $10 and receive a complimentary drink, or purchase a standard price right field porch seat for $25 and get two complimentary drinks. Right field porch seats include all-you-can-eat hot dogs, brats, burgers, chips, soda, and water from the time gates open until 2 hours after first pitch. You can find nightly drink specials out on the right field porch as well. So make plans to join us June 10th and 11th for Teachers Appreciation Weekend at Rivets Stadium.
We go to the third. We're experiencing right now the greatest dance-off in the history of dance-offs between the Kingfish mascot and the coaching, or no, a few of the players for the Kingfish. It's great theater right now in Kenosha. We are off to the third. It's going to be the lower third of the order for the Rivets. Cade Bunnell, Braden Williams, and David Cronin. And then the tackle. Brilliant entertainment, brilliant. That's awesome. Derek Cheetah, it sounds like his name is. And he's fantastic. Here comes Cade Bunnell to lead off this third inning. But now in his fourth game, he's 2-for-11. There's been a lot of roster turnover over the last week for Rockford. You'll get no pity from Kenosha. The pitch is a strike 0-1. Kenosha, before the season even started, had to cut 16 guys, whether it be grades or innings limits or something else. The 0-1, a strike 0-2. During this third inning, we'll give you a look at the out-of-town scoreboard. 10 games in the Northwoods League tonight, with Rochester and Mankato playing two. Here's the 0-2 inside, 1-2 to Cade Bunnell with Braden Williams on deck. And there's going to be a few thousand people rooting for Braden Williams to not be successful tonight. We'll get to that in a second. A 1-2. A check swing, an appeal down to third, and Kurt Arkenberg punches out Cade Bunnell. Three strikeouts for Reisinger, and here comes Braden Williams. Williams is the beer batter in the stadium tonight. Williams comes in 3-for-18 with four runs scored. Reisinger to Williams, and it's wide, 1-0. One ball and no strikes. Rocking to the wind, Reisinger. Here's his 1-0. It is taken low, 2-0. Is the count. Reisinger fires. A strike, it's 2-1. 2-1 the count. Williams from Texas Tech. His teammates in a super regional. The 2-1 is fouled back, 2-2. The Red Raiders will be hosting East Carolina this weekend in an NCAA Division I super regional. Williams was redshirted, that's why he's here. 2-2 the count. Reisinger fires. A swing and a miss, strike three. Four strikeouts for Reisinger, and it brings up David Cronin. Cronin, 4-for-25, 3 runs scored. Around the Northwoods League in game one of that doubleheader, in the bottom of the fourth, Mankato leading Rochester 13-0. First pitch from Cronin. Lays down a beautiful bunt. And it'll be an infield hit as O'Brien couldn't barehand it. It's the first hit of the night for the Rivets. And it will bring up Josh Hauser. Top of the third in Green Bay. Kalamazoo on top there, 7-0. Here's Josh Hauser. He walked back in the first. The pitch, Hauser shows bunt, takes the ball, and Cronin's back ahead of a pickoff throw. One ball, no strikes. Eau Claire leading St. Cloud, who has the longest winning streak in the league at 5. But the Express lead the Rocks 4-0 in the third. 1-0, Cronin not going. The pitch swung on, grounded towards Josie Walk. The throw across the diamond is off the bag, but making the tag is Jadaki, and the inning is over. We go to the last of the third. A hit and a man left. And we are still scoreless in Kenosha.
Join us at Rivets Stadium June 24th for a 6:35 p.m. first pitch against Wisconsin Rapids. Get to the ballpark early to see a human cannonball enter the stadium during the pregame. It's also the first night of a four-night Cheap Trick bobblehead series. Check out the awesome bobbleheads and enjoy a night out at the ballpark by calling 815-240-4159 or visiting rockfordrivets.com for tickets today.
Join us for the first fireworks night of the year on Saturday night, June 11th at 6:35 when the Rivets face the defending NWL champion Kenosha Kingfish. Enjoy a great night of baseball and cap it off with a spectacular fireworks show after the game. To get your tickets for fireworks night, go to rockfordrivets.com or call 815-240-4159.
Make plans to join us at Rivet Stadium every Friday home game after that long week of work for TGIF night at Rivet Stadium. You can get $3 beer specials from the time gates open until first pitch is delivered. So kick back and enjoy some Rivets baseball with a cold beer in hand. Our next TGIF night is June 24th versus the Wisconsin Rapids Raptors. Call 815-240-4159 or visit rockfordrivets.com for tickets today.
Back in Kenosha, no score as we go to the last of the third. We go to the nine-hole hitter, Cullen Josiewak. Josiewak, Hearn, and O'Brien against Cole Belair here in the third. Josiewak, a right-handed hitter. The shortstop for Kenosha. And Belair's first pitch is high, 1-0. So far, Belair with 3 strikeouts has given up a hit. The double by Schuler. A swing and a miss by Josiewak. It's 1-1. One ball and one strike is the count. Here's the pitch inside, 2-1. Two and one is the count. And the pitch is grounded to third. Nice play by Bunnell. His throw across the diamond is in time, and there's one down. It'll bring up Matt Hearn, who struck out in the first. Back to the scoreboard, bottom of the third at Warner Park. It is Madison 3, Lakeshore nothing. Wisconsin last night had their winning streak snapped. They lead tonight in the top of the fifth against Battle Creek, 4-2. Hearn, left-handed hitter, looks at ball one. It's 1-0. Duluth and Waterloo in the bottom of the second, scoreless. Here's the 1-0. Swung on, hit on the ground to Ramirez. It's a foot race to the bag, and he wins it. Two down. With two down, it's Kean O'Brien, who reached on an error in the first, and because there's two down, we better hustle through this scoreboard. It's the top of the third, Lacrosse 1, Wilmer nothing. And Thunder Bay, still looking for a win this year. They're 0-9. They're scoreless with Wisconsin Rapids in the second. The pitch inside to O'Brien, it's 1-0. That's a look at your out-of-town scoreboard. The 1-0 fouled off, 1-1. We'll have another look in the seventh. Here, there is no score to tell you about. Again, well pitched, as it was last night. 1-1 the count. The pitch is low, 2-1. And Belair working quickly, a ground ball up the middle, past Cronin and into center. Two out base runner. And this continues a theme for Kenosha. They've had at least one base runner in every inning. Here comes Cal Jadacki, who flew out to left center back in the first. Jadacki from the left side, the first baseman, with O'Brien at first and two down. And the first pitch is a fastball strike, 0-1. It was right about this time Friday night that pitching coach James Ferguson said that Belair simply gave up on his fastball. He abandoned it and ended up falling behind. The runner goes, the pitch fouled straight back, 0-2. And it was a great jump by O'Brien. But it's an 0-2 count now to Cal Jadacki. Jadacki, left-handed hitter. And he is out of St. Joe's. Here's the 0-2. It is swung on and missed. Nope, fouled at the plate, pardon me. Fouled at the plate. And it's still 0-2. It's a lively crowd here in Kenosha tonight. And a lot of them, 0-2. The pitch, high, 1-2. Nick Canavas is on deck if it gets there. Oh and two the count. Belair ready to bring it home to Jadacki. In the dirt, 2-2. Team had a very nice meal just next door at the Italian restaurant next door before heading over to the stadium today. It was delicious. No doubt about it. They know food in this part of the nation. 2-2, a runner on, two out. The pitch grounded towards Cronin. He stays with it, underhands to short, and the inning is over. The ball bounced off of Cronin. He recovered it and flipped it to Maloney to end the inning. We've played three, no runs, a hit, and a man left. It's still scoreless.
Join us Wednesday, June 29th at 11 a.m. as the Rivets take on the Madison Mallards for Kids Day at the ballpark. Your $10 ticket includes a voucher for a hot dog, soda, and a bag of chips. What better way to spend a sunny summer day than your child falling in love with the game of baseball? Enjoy Kids Day on June 29th out at the ballpark by calling 815-240-4159 or visiting RockfordRivets.com for tickets today.
Make plans to join us at Rivet Stadium every Thursday home game for Thirsty Thursday at 6:35. You can get $2 beer specials in the right field porch. So kick back and enjoy some baseball with a cold beer in hand. Our next Thirsty Thursday is June 23rd versus the Wisconsin Rapids Raptors. So call 815-240-4159 or visit RockfordRivets.com for tickets today.
Join us June 10th for Mystery Envelope Night at Rivets Stadium. The first 500 fans will receive a mystery envelope with the contents inside unknown until later in the game. You could win one of several prizes, from tickets to cold, hard cash. You don't want to miss it. June 10th at 6:35 against Kenosha. Make plans to be at Rivets Stadium and get your prize.
After the 9-month grind of teaching the entire school year, those poor souls need a getaway. Well, fear not, because baseball is the answer. Join us Friday and Saturday night, June 10th and 11th at 6:35 for Teachers Appreciation Weekend at Rivet Stadium as Rockford hosts the defending Northwoods League champion Kenosha Kingfish for a two-game series. Get an infield reserve seat for the standard $10 and receive a complimentary drink, or purchase a standard price right field porch seat for $25 and get two complimentary drinks. Right field porch seats include all-you-can-eat hot dogs, brats, burgers, chips, soda, and water from the time gates open until 2 hours after first pitch. You can find nightly drink specials out on the right field porch as well. So make plans to join us June 10th and 11th for Teachers Appreciation Weekend at Rivet Stadium.
We go to the fourth. It is Jacob Vanderwall who grounded into a fielder's choice in the first and then was picked off 1-3-6. He'll be followed by Alex Maloney and Ricardo Ramirez. No score in the fourth, no runs, one hit, one error, and one left for the Rivets. The pitch is low, no runs, two hits, no errors, and three left for the Kingfish. 1-0, the pitch is a strike, it's 1-1. From here, both teams will meet again tomorrow at Rivets Stadium and continue this four-game series. A swing and a miss, 1-2. And on that note, you really should be at the ballpark this weekend. Hey, it's going to be 90-plus degrees. Where else are you going to go? The 1-2 is low, 2-2. Two and two is the count. And here's the pitch. Swing and a miss. Down goes Vanderwall. Strikeout number 5 for Andrew Reisinger. And it brings up Alex Maloney. Join us for the first fireworks night of the year on Saturday at 6:35 when the Rivets face these same Kingfish. Enjoy a great night of baseball and cap it off with a spectacular fireworks show after the game. To get your tickets for fireworks night, go to RockfordRivets.com or call 815-240-4159. Ball one wide to Alex Maloney, who struck out in the first inning. And don't you dare forget to join us tomorrow night for Mystery Envelope Night at Rivets Stadium. Did you see social media today? Here's a 1-0. Grounded down to the third baseman, O'Brien. His throw across the diamond in time, two away. The reason I ask you about that, the first 500 fans will receive a mystery envelope. If you checked out the Facebook page, you know that there's some good stuff that's going to be in those, but you won't know what's inside until later in the game. You could win one of several prizes, tickets, passes, even cold hard cash up to $100. You don't want to miss it. Tomorrow, 6:35 against Kenosha. Make plans to be at Rivets Stadium. First pitch, ball one to Ricardo Ramirez, who struck out back in the second. You might walk into that stadium with $20 and leave with $100. Here's the 1-0, low 2-0. Tell me that doesn't sound like a good deal. Of course it does. Leaving with $100 that you didn't even have to work for? Woo, two thumbs up. Here's the 2-0. A swing and a high fly foul, 2-1. Somebody going to give me $100, I'm showing up to the ball yard. That's what I'm doing. 2-1 is the count. Ramirez, right-handed hitter against the righty Risinger. Here's the pitch. Swung on and lined to center field. The second hit of the night for the Rivets. On that hitting note by Joshua Kine, he talked to me a lot before BP about pulling off the baseball. And granted, it's easier to talk about than to do during the game. But it is a simple adjustment with these wood bats, with weight transfer that these guys have to undertake. Here's Corey Wright, a ground out to second back in the second. The pitch inside and gets away from Schuler and Ramirez down to second. It's a pass ball against Schuler. And a 1-0 count to Corey Wright. Anyway, Keimer was talking about the spin as you swing. If you fly too open and try and pull the baseball, you can't hit the sweet spot. He then pulled out a bat, and he said Jordan Hovey pulled out so quickly the other night, pulled off the ball so quickly that he actually broke not the barrel of the bat, the top circle of the bat. Jordan Hovey shattered the other night because he was so far out in front. First time tonight for the Rivets to have a runner in scoring position. And we talked about their struggles, 177 as a team in these spots. Outside, 2-0. And it's even worse on the road, where the Rivets are hitting 153 with runners in scoring position. Both of these teams struggling in that category badly. Kenosha now with their 0-for-3 back in the second inning, they're now hitting below 100 in those spots. The 2-0 is wide, it's 3-0. Three and oh is the count. Three and oh the count. Might not be a terrible play to just put Corey Wright on and set up the force. Here's the 3-0 from Risinger. He stretches and fires, and it's a strike, 3-1. Neil Tyrell is on deck that far. We are in the top of the fourth. There is no score in the ball game. So glad you could join us tonight. BJ Walters with you in Kenosha. It's a beautiful town. It's a lot bigger than I thought it would be, and I was informed that it is the third largest town in Wisconsin. Behind Madison, here's the pitch, fouled away, still 3-2. Behind, of course, Madison, Wisconsin, and Milwaukee, Wisconsin. 3-2 is the count. A nice job battling back by Andrew Risinger. 3-2. And the righty stretches at the belt. He's set. And the payoff is swung on and grounded down to first. The flip on to the pitcher by Jadaki is in time and the inning is over. We go to the home fourth. Still scoreless in a great pitcher's duel in Kenosha tonight.
Join us at Rivet Stadium June 24th for a 6:35 p.m. first pitch against Wisconsin Rapids. Get to the ballpark early to see a human cannonball enter the stadium during the pregame. It's also the first night of a four-night Cheap Trick bobblehead series. Check out the awesome bobbleheads and enjoy a night out at the ballpark by calling 815-240-4159 or visiting rockfordrivets.com for tickets today.
Join us for the first fireworks night of the year on Saturday night, June 11th at 6:35 when the Rivets face the defending NWL champion Kenosha Kingfish. Enjoy a great night of baseball and cap it off with a spectacular fireworks show after the game. To get your tickets for fireworks night, go to rockfordrivets.com or call 815-240-4159.
Make plans to join us at Rivet Stadium every Friday home game after that long week of work for TGIF night at Rivet Stadium. You can get $3 beer specials from the time gates open until first pitch is delivered. So kick back and enjoy some Rivets baseball with a cold beer in hand. Our next TGIF night is June 24th versus the Wisconsin Rapids Raptors. Call 815-240-4159 or visit rockfordrivets.com for tickets today.
Headed to the bottom of the fourth here in Kenosha. No score. It'll be Nick Canavas, Pete Schuler, and Mason Fishback against Cole Belair, who's been very good so far through three, giving up just the two hits. The one error behind him, and he's worked his way around it. Canavas, a strikeout victim back in the first. Right-handed hitter. And Canavas is out of Madison College, 6'1", 200-pound sophomore. And he hits a ground ball towards Maloney. The throw across the diamond in time, one pitch, one out. Just how Cole Belair had it drawn up. And Pete Schuler's the hitter. Schuler almost had his third home run of the year back in the second. It ended up being a double off the base of the right center field wall. Schuler was stranded, though. He never moved off of second, and ball one here. Rockford's new club has gone social. Like us on Facebook and follow us on Twitter, Instagram, and Snapchat for all the latest news and highlights from your Rivets all summer long. The 1-0 fouled straight back, 1-1. One and one the count. Belair rocks and fires. It's wide. Two balls and a strike. That's ball three wide. 3-1 out of nowhere to the lefty Schuler. Here comes a 3-1. Swung on and hit in the air down the line and right. That's headed for the wall. That's going to be another double, it looks like. It will with one out. Schuler into second with his second double in as many at bats. We're here in the fourth. Here comes Mason Fishback, a fly out to right in his first at bat. Schuler at second, one out, the pitch. Swing and a miss. The ball escapes Williams. And on the pass ball, Schuler takes third. A big opportunity now for the Kingfish to take the lead. One strike to count. Runner at third. And one out. Infield in for the Rivets. Here's the 0-1. A swing and a miss, 0-2. 0-2 the count. Oh and two, the infield in all the way around. Belair ready. The pitch. A little topper down to Maloney. He'll check the runner and throw out Fish back. And these two teams feel each other's pain. Now 8 for 82 on the year with runners in scoring position, the Kingfish. Here comes Wes Weeks, and I think you'd say the same thing for Kenosha that you've been saying for Rockford. Once they get one, they're going to get four and five and six, and they're going to hang a 15 on somebody. The pitch is a strike. It's 0-1 to Wes Weeks, who popped out to short in his first at bat. Once they get one clutch hit, the clutch hits will just be very contagious. The 0-1, a pop-up on the infield. This should be Cronin. It is. And Belair gets out of it. We go to the fifth. No runs, a hit, and a man left. We are still scoreless on a fantastic night at Simmons Field in Wisconsin.
Join us Wednesday, June 29th at 11 a.m. as the Rivets take on the Madison Mallards for Kids Day at the ballpark. Your $10 ticket includes a voucher for a hot dog, soda, and a bag of chips. What better way to spend a sunny summer day than your child falling in love with the game of baseball? Enjoy Kids Day on June 29th out at the ballpark by calling 815-240-4159 or visiting rockfordrivets.com for tickets today.
Make plans to join us at Rivet Stadium every Thursday home game for Thirsty Thursday at 6:35. You can get $2 beer specials in the right field porch. So kick back and enjoy some baseball with a cold beer in hand. Our next Thirsty Thursday is June 23rd versus the Wisconsin Rapids Raptors. So call 815-240-4159 or visit rockfordrivets.com for tickets today.
Join us June 10th for Mystery Envelope Night at Rivets Stadium. The first 500 fans will receive a mystery envelope with the contents inside unknown until later in the game. You could win one of several prizes, from tickets to cold, hard cash. You don't want to miss it. June 10th at 6:35 against Kenosha. Make plans to be at Rivets Stadium and get your prize.
Well, Rivets right-hander Zachary Ehring is no more. He's been eaten by the Kingfish wearing the Michael Jordan jersey. Yep, he's gone. Adios, muchacho. We go to the fifth. It will be Neil Tyrell, Cade Bunnell, and Braden. Well, no. Well, Zach Ehring just became, no pun intended here, the butt of a lot of jokes later on. Yep, it had to be somebody. And the guys will never play that down because they're baseball players. Neil Tyrell. For those wondering, Ehring was spit out in just his undies by the Kingfish. Neil Tyrell grounded out to short in the second. We've got another pitcher's duel on our hands between these two. It's scoreless into the fifth. And Andrew Reisinger throws his first pitch. A chopper down to third. O'Brien, the throw across the diamond, one down. On one pitch, here's one out for Cade Bunnell, who struck out in the third. Erring, by the way, on Tuesday, only went an inning because of the pitch count rule. So he needed that workout that he was given by the Kingfish mascot. The pitch is a strike, it's 0-1. Rockford needs a mascot. How do you make a mascot out of rivets, though? Here's the 0-1 outside, 1-1. That was actually a topic of discussion in the office today, trying to brainstorm how you get a mascot out of the rivets. Who knows? Here's a 1-1. Fastball swing and a miss by Cade Bunnell. It's 1-2. Thank goodness there are smarter minds than myself in that office. Thank goodness. Here comes a 1-2. A little bit inside, 2-2. 2-2 is a count. Here comes a 2-2. Off speed, swung on and missed strike three. Six strikeouts for Andrew Reisinger. And Braden Williams was a victim of one back in the third. He'll hit here with nobody on and two out in the fifth. The game moving big time. First pitch on the way. Low, 1-0. One ball and no strikes. Reisinger ready, in a good rhythm here, his 1-0 wide. 2-0 to the catcher from Irving in Texas. Braden Williams, MacArthur High School. Here's a 2-0. A swing and a miss, 2-1. Here comes a 2-1, Reisinger. Rocks, kicks, and fires it home. A low pitch, 3-1. And the Kenosha fans wanted that one. You can understand why. It was not a bad pitch whatsoever at all. So Williams way out ahead, the 3-1. Swung on, grounded to the shortstop, Joswalk. The throw across the diamond is high, and it pulls off the first baseman, Jadacki. It's going to be a single for Braden Williams. Third hit, it'll bring up David Cronin, who laid down a bunt single back in the third. The hits tonight, all singles, Ramirez, Cronin, and Williams. The Rivets are now on YouTube, but you already know that because you're listening to the game. Subscribe to our channel today for interviews, highlights, and more. Just search Rockford Rivets on YouTube and click on subscribe to get riveted this summer. First pitch, Cronin lines one down the left field line. It slices foul. And it's 0-1. Nothing in one is the count. We talked to a lot of the fine folks here in Kenosha, and they said pretty much this. Our starters are good. Yep, par for the course through two games of this series. Here's the 0-1 from Reisinger. Time called by Cronin. They do still have bullpen concerns. And suffice to say, both these teams have hitting concerns, especially the Rivets. 0-1 the count. The pitch by Reisinger, outside, 1-1. Next time the Rivets are on the road is Sunday. But don't be fooled. Starting Sunday, 6 out of 8 on the road. The only home games are two-gamer with Battle Creek Tuesday and Wednesday. Pickoff throw back is Williams. It has been a road-heavy schedule for the Rockford Rivets so far. But it doesn't seem that way. Mainly because of that opening three-game homestand. 1-1 the count. Williams holds the pitch. A strike, 1-2. 4 of the last 6 have been away from Rivets Stadium. This game will make that 5 out of 7. Make plans to be at Rivets Stadium tomorrow night. How about you do that? RockfordRivets.com. Here's the 1-2. Williams is back on a pickoff throw. Or you can call us up in the morning. You know what? Office hours are 9 to 5. I'll let you in on a secret. If you call at 8:30, we'll get you some tickets. 815-240-4159. 1-2 the count. The stretch. And Reisinger brings it home on 1-2. Outside 2-2. The Rivets continue this four-game set with Kenosha tomorrow night at 6:35. Right-hander Ethan Howard will take the hill against Kingfish righty Derek Heffel. Join us at 6:20 for all the action, starting with the Northwoods League pregame show. Make plans to join us tomorrow night for Kenosha and the Rivets on Northwoods League TV. 2-2, Williams at first, 2 away. The pitch inside, and Williams will get a head start on 3-2. Three and two is the count. Williams will go on this payoff. The stretch by Reisinger. The lefty Cronin waits. There goes the runner. The pitch, a swing and a miss, strike three. 7 strikeouts for Reisinger, and we go to the bottom of the fifth. Halfway through the middle of the fifth after 4.5. No score in Kenosha.
After the 9-month grind of teaching the entire school year, those poor souls need a getaway. Well, fear not, because baseball is the answer. Join us Friday and Saturday night, June 10th and 11th at 6:35 for Teachers Appreciation Weekend at Rivets Stadium as Rockford hosts the defending Northwoods League champion Kenosha Kingfish for a two-game series. Get an infield reserve seat for the standard $10 and receive a complimentary drink, or purchase a standard price right field porch seat for $25 and get 2 complimentary drinks. Right field porch seats include all-you-can-eat hot dogs, brats, burgers, chips, soda, and water from the time gates open until 2 hours after first pitch. You can find nightly drink specials out on the right field porch as well. So make plans to join us June 10th and 11th for Teachers Appreciation Weekend at Rivets Stadium. Join us at Rivets Stadium June 24th for a 6:35 p.m. first pitch against Wisconsin Rapids. Get to the ballpark early to see a human cannonball enter the stadium during the pregame. It's also the first night of a four-night Cheap Trick bobblehead series. Check out the awesome bobbleheads and enjoy a night out at the ballpark by calling 815-240-4159 or visiting RockfordRivets.com for tickets today.
Join us for the first fireworks night of the year on Saturday night, June 11th at 6:35, when the Rivets face the defending NWL champion Kenosha Kingfish. Enjoy a great night of baseball and cap it off with a spectacular fireworks show after the game. To get your tickets for fireworks night, go to RockfordRivets.com or call 815-240-4159.
Want to follow the Rivets on the road, but gas prices are too steep? No worries, because the Rivets have you covered. Just go to our YouTube page, Rockford Rivets, for every road game broadcast for free in 2016, including our next one, Sunday afternoon in Rapids against the Wisconsin Rapids Raptors, starting at 3:45. YouTube, your home for every Rivets road game. First pitch, a curveball strike to Jack Yalowitz. It's the teammate matchup. Belair and Yalowitz, which Belair won with a strikeout. In the second inning. Here it's 1-1. Belair fires it home. It's a little bit wide, 2-1. Yalowitz, Joswak, and Hearn in the fifth. Here's a 2-1. Outside ball three. Three and one the count. Here comes Belair to the plate. That's a strike, 3-2. Yalowitz thought it was ball four. Now the payoff from Cole Belair. It's on the way. A little chopper foul. Foul is the call. And it's still 3-2. Braden Williams looked to the dugout as if to say, can we get him to talk? But no such luck. It's still 3-2. Here comes the payoff. Swung on and lined out towards center. Vanderwall loses it in the lights, makes a diving catch anyway. And there is the light issue. Vanderwall completely lost it. And then found it just in time to dive to his left and make the play. There's one down. Here's Cullen Joswak. A ground out down to third in his first at bat. First pitch, butting for a hit, it's foul. 0-1. That's the first time we've seen what our assistant general manager talked to me about this morning, Bill Shia, talked about how the lights, once they take effect, will play with this defense, especially the Rivets, especially tonight, because they have not played here before. The pitch outside, 1-1. One ball, one strike, the count. And the pitch bounced in, 2-1. Two and one is the count. Belair brings it. Low, 3-1. 9-hole hitter here. Here's the 3-1. Hit in the air to left. Hauser has it all the way, 2 down. Here comes Matt Hearn, a ground out to first and a strikeout swinging in the ball game. We're in the last of the fifth. There is still no score in a well-pitched ball game. The Rivets trying for back-to-back wins for the first time in franchise history. They have won two of their last three, though. The pitch is grounded towards short. Maloney has it come up on him. Should be an E6, perhaps. It is an E6. Second error of the night against the Rivets. Kean O'Brien reached on an error in the first and singled and was forced out in the third. So he's been on both times. Good hitter from the right side, Kean O'Brien. Runner goes, the pitch low and a stolen base for Joswak. Rather for Hearn, pardon me. That is a steal for Hearn. Joseph Walk was the second out. And it's 1-0, and Hearn getting looked at by the third base coach, but he's fine. And an RBI opportunity for Kenosha. Kingfish nothing, Rivets nothing in the fifth. 0-1 count to Kean O'Brien. The stretch by Cole Belair with the runner at second and two men down. And now Belair's pitch. A swing and a chopper towards Maloney. He fields it, throws to first in time, and the inning is over. We've played five, and there's no score in Kenosha tonight.
Make plans to join us at Rivet Stadium every Friday home game after that long week of work for TGIF night at Rivet Stadium. You can get $3 beer specials from the time gates open until first pitch is delivered. So kick back and enjoy some Rivets baseball with a cold beer in hand. Our next TGIF night is June 24th versus the Wisconsin Rapids Raptors. Call 815-240-4159 or visit rockfordrivets.com for tickets today.
Join us Wednesday, June 29th at 11 a.m. as the Rivets take on the Madison Mallards for Kids Day at the ballpark. Your $10 ticket includes a voucher for a hot dog, soda, and a bag of chips. What better way to spend a sunny summer day than your child falling in love with the game of baseball? Enjoy Kids Day on June 29th out at the ballpark by calling 815-240-4159 or visiting rockfordrivets.com for tickets today.
Make plans to join us at Rivet Stadium every Thursday home game for Thirsty Thursday at 6:35. You can get $2 beer specials in the right field porch. So kick back and enjoy some baseball with a cold beer in hand. Our next Thirsty Thursday is June 23rd versus the Wisconsin Rapids Raptors. So call 815-240-4159 or visit rockfordrivets.com for tickets today.
Heading into the sixth, it's scoreless here in Kenosha. It will be the top of the lineup in the third time through against Andrew Reisinger, Josh Hauser, Jacob Vanderwall, and Alex Maloney. Reisinger's been fantastic tonight. He has struck out seven, walked just one, and given up just three hits. Both teams with only three hits so far in the ball game. It's a nice cool evening tonight. It will not be that way tomorrow. We're talking about a 30 degree difference tomorrow. It's going to be 95 degrees at first pitch. It's going to be a scorcher in Rockford. Here comes Josh Hauser. A ground out victim in the third to short and a walk before he was forced out in the first. I'm not going to say it's going to be miserable, but don't bundle up is all I'll say about tomorrow. Do not bundle up, but be there. Be there because it's Mystery Envelope Night. It's Teachers Appreciation Weekend. It's a TGIF night at the ballpark. First pitch to Hauser, a check swing, the appeal to first, and Cole Lockhart puts a fist in the air. It's 0-1. Looked like he went from here. It's 0-1. Rocking to the wind, Reisinger. The pitch, a slider strike 0-2. The Belvedere native, two strikes behind in the count. Here's the 0-2. Fouled straight back, still 0-2. Oh and two the count. Reisinger stretches and brings it home. Outside 1-2. One and two the count. Reisinger rocks, kicks, brings it home. Slider hit back towards the middle. Tough play for Joseph Walk. Throw to first is in time. Nice play by the shortstop. And there's one down. Here's Jacob Vanderwall, grounded into a fielder's choice, was picked off in the first and struck out in the fourth. Nothing in the sixth. If you're just joining us, it's been the pitcher's duel even more so than it was last night over in Rockford. Reisinger brings it home, and Vanderwall showed bunt and took a strike. So and one. Owen won the count. Reisinger from the first base side fires. Swung on and grounded down to first. The flip to the pitcher by Jadacki in time. And there's two away. Two away for Alex Maloney, a strikeout victim and a ground out to third. There is no action in the Rivets bullpen. There is some movement in the Kingfish bullpen, but not much happening at the moment. These two starters have been on their game. And here comes Maloney, the Ball State product. 6'2", 185 from Chelsea, Michigan. The son of Ball State's coach. And the first pitch is a strike to Maloney. It's possible that Hunter Steinmetz could make his Rivets debut tomorrow night. The pitch a strike, it's 0-2. And you can bet that because of the struggles of the lineup, Smitty's gonna throw him in there and say, it's not gonna go any worse. 0-2 the count. The pitch outside. 1-2 from Andrew Reisinger. Yes, opposing pitchers have been good against the Rivets, but at some point you can't just give everybody credit. You have to take the blame for not hitting as well as you'd like. Here's the 1-2. Slider, did he offer? They'll appeal down to first. No swing. 2-2. Looked like a swing from up here, but the first base umpire, Cole Lockhart, had a much better view than we did, and it's 2-2. Maloney's still up there. Here comes a 2-2. Outside, overthrowing that one was Reisinger, and the count has gone full. This will only be the 13th pitch of the inning for the righty, and overall the 86th pitch. So he might come back for the 7th, but the 8th is looking a little shaky at the moment. Here comes the payoff to Maloney. It's strike three, call over the outside corner. 8 strikeouts for Reisinger, and we are in the middle of the 6th, still scoreless.
Join us June 10th for Mystery Envelope Night at Rivets Stadium. The first 500 fans will receive a mystery envelope with the contents inside unknown until later in the game. You could win one of several prizes, from tickets to cold, hard cash. You don't want to miss it. June 10th at 6:35 against Kenosha. Make plans to be at Rivets Stadium and get your prize.
After the 9-month grind of teaching the entire school year, those poor souls need a getaway. Well, fear not, because baseball is the answer. Join us Friday and Saturday night, June 10th and 11th at 6:35 for Teachers Appreciation Weekend at Rivets Stadium as Rockford hosts the defending Northwoods League champion Kenosha Kingfish for a 2-game series. Get an infield reserve seat for the standard $10 and receive a complimentary drink, or purchase a standard price right field porch seat for $25 and get 2 complimentary drinks. Right field porch seats include all-you-can-eat hot dogs, brats, burgers, chips, soda, and water from the time gates open until 2 hours after first pitch. You can find nightly drink specials out on the right field porch as well. So make plans to join us June 10th and 11th for Teachers Appreciation Weekend at Rivets Stadium.
Fantastic pitcher's duel here. No score. into the last of the sixth in Kenosha tonight. Cole Belair goes back out there. Second straight night that the Rivets have gotten their starter into the sixth. And it will be the heart of the order, Jadaki, Canavas, and Schuler against a righty from Lockport. Righty-lefty matchup here. Jadaki a fly out to center and grounded into a fielder's choice in the ball game. Third baseman in, that's Bunnell against the possible bunt from a three-hole hitter. And the pitch is a strike, 0-1. Cole Belair has been fantastic, allowing just three hits. There's been two errors behind him. The big key for him is he has not walked anybody. The pitch wide, 1-1. He has struck out three to this point. 1-1. Belair rocks, kicks, and fires home. A slider just missed outside. 2-1. Rivets will host the Kingfish tomorrow night and Saturday night. The 2-1 swing and a miss off speed. 2-2. Before heading to Rapids, Wisconsin to meet the Raptors for the first time this year. 2-2 is the count. Belair gets his sign from Williams and brings it home. Fastball fouled at the plate and off of the home plate, umpire Jeff Heyman. Heyman, ouch, that's not gonna feel good. Two and two still the count. Williams went out to talk to Belair and give Heyman a minute. Now the pitch swung on, grounded to Cronin. His throw to Ramirez, and there's one down. Here comes Nick Canavas. A strikeout in the first and a ground out to short in the fourth. Mankato and Rochester are going to be playing deep into the evening. They're playing a doubleheader tonight, and the first game isn't over yet. And it's not over because Mankato brought out the big lumber tonight. 17-0 Moondogs in game one of a doubleheader. That's not fun if you're Rochester. There's a second game to come, and they'll be begging that Houston Glad can give them some innings. A full league scoreboard coming in the seventh. One down in the last of the sixth, and here's Canavas from the right side. Belair fires it home. Showing bunt, taking a ball was Canavas. It's 1-0. So far for Belair, that was only pitch number 73. There is action in the Rivets bullpen. A swing and a miss, 1-1. And it's Anthony Dahl getting up. And let me tell you this, Fergie, James Ferguson, the pitching coach. 1-1, swing and a miss, 1-2. He's got to be loving life. He's got Anthony Dahl, 6'5", throwing gas. And now he's got the big fella, big country. Our pregame guest, Tyler Thornton, throwing 96 miles an hour. 1-2 the count to Nick Canavas. Here comes the 1-2. Chopped on the ground to third. Hey! That's a really nice play by the third base coach over there, Stephen Huff. Here's the 1-2. It's wide. 2-2. Pete Schuler, who has doubled twice. He's got two of the three hits for Kenosha. He's on deck. The 2-2. Swing and a little chopper towards Maloney. Tough play. Throw to first will be late. Infield hit for Nick Canavas. One out single. Fourth hit of the night for the Kingfish. And it will bring up the very dangerous Schuler, who has doubled to right center and doubled to right. Left-handed hitter Schuler from Kent State, 6'3", 180. It seems obvious to myself, at least, Schuler's their best hitter. James Ferguson will go out and have a strategy talk with Cole Belair. And this is, hey, let's not make a mistake and get beat right here. Let's make sure that after this at bat, we're still in the game. Make plans to join us at Rivet Stadium every Thursday home game for Thirsty Thursday at 6:35. Thirsty Thursday means you can get $2 beer specials in the right field porch. So kick back and enjoy some baseball with a cold beer in hand. Our next Thirsty Thursday is June 23rd against the Rapids Rafters. So call 815-240-4159 or visit rockfordrivets.com for tickets today. Middle infield of Maloney and Cronin play for two. Runner at first, one down, Pete Schuler the hitter. And Belair's pitch is low, 1-0. Action in the Kingfish bullpen, a lefty is throwing. Belair ready, the pitch taken high, 2-0. 2-0 the count. Mason Fishback is on deck. Here's a 2-0. Swung on, hit in the air, shallow center. On comes Vanderwall, out goes Maloney to make the play. And there's two down. And here comes Fishback. 0-2 with a ground out to Maloney and a fly out to Corey Wright in right. Fishback, a right-handed hitter from New Mexico State, the Aggies. Runner goes, the pitch inside, gets away from Braden Williams, and now headed to third. The throw there is in time, inning over. Nick Canavas steals second. It's a wild pitch, and then he's thrown out 2-5 to end the inning. And we have played six tonight with no score in Kenosha.
Join us at Rivet Stadium June 24th for a 6:35 p.m. first pitch against Wisconsin Rapids. Get to the ballpark early to see a human cannonball enter the stadium during the pregame. It's also the first night of a four-night Cheap Trick bobblehead series. Check out the awesome bobbleheads and enjoy a night out at the ballpark by calling 815-240-4159 or visiting rockfordrivets.com for tickets today.
Join us for the first fireworks night of the year on Saturday night, June 11th at 6:35 when the Rivets face the defending NWL champion Kenosha Kingfish. Enjoy a great night of baseball and cap it off with a spectacular fireworks show after the game. To get your tickets for fireworks night,
Go to RockfordRivets.com or call 815-240-4159.
Make plans to join us at Rivet Stadium every Friday home game after that long week of work for TGIF night at Rivet Stadium. You can get $3 beer specials from the time gates open until first pitch is delivered. So kick back and enjoy some Rivets baseball with a cold beer in hand. Our next TGIF night is June 24th versus the Wisconsin Rapids Raptors. Call 815-240-4159 or visit RockfordRivets.com for tickets today.
Rigo Beltran, the new pitcher. Beltran, a lefty, 5'11", 185 from Delray Beach, Florida and Lynn University. And Beltran comes in with a 1-1 record and a 3 ERA. In three innings, he's given up two hits, a run, no walks and six strikeouts. So already Beltran with two decisions. The lefty will come in after Andrew Reisinger, who will not get a win, will not get a loss, will not get anything tonight, went six innings, gave up three hits, no runs, one walk, eight strikeouts. His walk was to Josh Hauser starting the game. So Rigo Beltran is in. And he will face Ricardo Ramirez, Corey Wright, and Neil Tyrell. The 4-5-6 hitters for the Rivets. Through six innings, no runs, three hits, two errors for the Rivets. No runs, four hits, no errors for the Kingfish. A swing and a miss by Ramirez, 0-1. Rivets have left three, Kingfish have left five. In fact, the sixth inning was the first inning that they didn't leave a man. Here's the 0-1 from Beltran. Outside, 1-1. Looks like it's a bullpen game because Dahl is just about there in the Rivets bullpen. And it looks like the 6-5 righty from Arkansas will get the bottom half. Here's the 1-1. Swung on, fouled straight back, 1-2. One and two the count. One and two the count. The stretch. And here's the pitch. High, and it's 2-2. Two and two the count. Beltran ready. Here it is. Swung on, fouled off, still 2-2. Good AB by Ricardo Ramirez. Two and two again. Beltran ready. And the pitch is low, 3-2. I really don't want to be that guy, but the forecast in the next hour and a half doesn't look great here. Here's the 3-2. Swung on, fouled off, still 3-2. So it might be to the benefit of both teams to go ahead and find a winner here, maybe in regulation, maybe in just the one extra inning. Still 3-2 to Ricardo Ramirez. He'll be followed by Wright and Tyrell. It's been a good at-bat. This will be the eighth pitch of it to Ramirez. 3-2. The pitch. Swung on, grounded down to the third baseman O'Brien. His throw across is high and not in time. An E5. Ramirez aboard on the first error tonight by Kenosha. And this is the first time the Rivets have had their leadoff man on since the first inning in Josh Hauser. Corey Wright, two ground outs, one to second, one to first in the game. Ramirez at first, one down, and Wright gets the bunt down. Beltran throws to first off the glove of the first baseman, and moving down to third is Ramirez. A big time scoring opportunity for the Rivets on the E3. It's a sacrifice and an E3, and they're on the corners with nobody out. 4-0 Tyrell. Back-to-back errors to begin the inning. So Ramirez at third, right at first, and nobody out in the top of the seventh inning. You would almost call this a must-score situation for the Rivets as it begins to rain lightly here at the ballpark. So the rain has begun here in Kenosha. Long meeting here before Neil Tyrell steps in. Two men on, nobody out. And a very important moment in the game. Beltran has seen two errors behind him. First pitch to Tyrell, swing and a miss, 0-1. Oh, and won the count. Tyrell, the designated hitter, against the lefty, Beltran. And a pickoff throw back is right. Beltran, as we mentioned, already has a win and a loss this season. So when he comes into the game, things happen. The pitch. A bunt. Neil Tyrell is going to get the run home, and he's going to reach himself. No, he's going to be out at first. But the safety squeeze RBI scores Ramirez, and it's 1-0 Rivets. Moving to second is Corey Wright. And it will bring up Cade Bunnell. 1-0 Rockford. Lefty-lefty matchup here for Cade Bunnell, who has struck out twice tonight. And now calling time and going out to the mound is Pete Schuler. Schuler back behind the plate. We remind you tomorrow night, Mystery Envelope night, TGIF night, and the beginning of Teacher Appreciation Weekend at Rivets Stadium. It's a 6:35 first pitch. Make your plans to be there. First pitch, a strike over the inside edge to Cade Bunnell. It's 0-1. Nothing in one is the count. Bunnell, closed stance. Here's the 0-1. Outside, 1-1. What that run means is that Cole Belair is in line to get a win. tonight for Rockford. Here's the 1-1. Swing and a miss. Bunnell swinging for the downs, and it's 1-2. One ball and two strikes. The Rivets winning their first ever one-run game on Monday night, winning another one last night, and now they lead by one here. The 1-2 from Beltran. That's low. 2-2. Two and two is the count. Two and two. Lefty-lefty matchup, and Beltran works on the extreme first base side of the pitching rubber. Bunnell calls time, and again back out to the mound goes Schuler. So right now the only RBI tonight is on a bunt. Neil Tyrell with the safety squeeze this inning. 2-2 is the count. Braden Williams is on deck. 2-2. The stretch and the pitch from Beltran. Slider didn't slide. 3-2. It's gone as far as it's going to go. 3-2. Three and two the count. Beltran comes set at the letters. The pitch outside and two are on. Second walk for the Rivets tonight, and now it'll be Braden Williams. Williams a single back in the fifth and a strikeout swinging in the third. Two men on, man out. One runner home so far in the inning without the benefit of a hit. Rivets have been out hit 4-3, the errors hurting Kenosha this inning. Lefty-lefty matchup, and the pitch is a strike. It's 0-1. Nothing and one the count. Beltran, the lefty, working to the lefty Williams. And he brings home an 0-1. Hit on the ground to third. Going the short way to second to get the middle man was O'Brien down to Hearn. And there's two down with runners on the corners. And it will bring up David Cronin, the nine-hole hitter. Cronin, a strikeout in the fifth and a bunt single in the third. Again, Schuler out to the mound. Don't forget, Saturday night is fireworks night at the ballpark. You'll get to see the Rivets in the final game of this series with the Kingfish. You'll get to see Nick Camarada pitch, and then you'll get to see fireworks. Lefty-lefty matchup, runners on the corners, two men out here in the seventh. And the pitch, showing bump was Cronin. He took a strike, it's 0-1. Two outs in the inning. Runners on the corners. Williams at first, right at third. Nothing in one to the Illinois Chicago second baseman, David Cronin. From Orland Park, a swing and a foul off to the left, 0-2. Andrew Reisinger, six fantastic innings for Kenosha, a no decision tonight. No action in the Kingfish bullpen. This is all Rigo Beltran. 0-2 the count. The pitch, a swing and a miss. He struck him out and the inning is over. But one run on no hits, two errors and two left. Stretch time at the ball yard. New score, Rivets 1, Kingfish nothing.
Join us Wednesday, June 29th at 11 a.m. as the Rivets take on the Madison Mallards for Kids Day at the ballpark. Your $10 ticket includes a voucher for a hot dog, soda, and a bag of chips. What better way to spend a sunny summer day than your child falling in love with the game of baseball? Enjoy Kids Day on June 29th out at the ballpark by calling 815-240-4159 or visiting rockfordrivets.com for tickets today.
Make plans to join us at Rivet Stadium every Thursday home game for Thirsty Thursday at 6:35. You can get $2 beer specials in the right field porch. So kick back and enjoy some baseball with a cold beer in hand. Our next Thirsty Thursday is June 23rd versus the Wisconsin Rapids Raptors. So call 815-240-4159 or visit rockfordrivets.com for tickets today.
Join us June 10th for Mystery Envelope Night at Rivets Stadium. The first 500 fans will receive a mystery envelope with the contents inside unknown until later in the game. You could win one of several prizes, from tickets to cold, hard cash. You don't want to miss it. June 10th at 6:35 against Kenosha. Make plans to be at Rivets Stadium and get your prize.
New pitcher for the Rivets is the big right-hander, 6'5", 200-pounder from Angleton, Texas, by way of Arkansas. It's Anthony Dahl. Dahl's been very good this year, having only given up runs in the one game in Madison on Friday evening. The final line on Cole Belair, who was just fantastic. Six innings, four hits, no runs, no walks, three strikeouts. And now Anthony Dahl, who's been really, really good in his three games, is in. Dahl, tall right-hander, will face Fishback, Weeks, and Yellowitz in the seventh. 82 pitches through a very good six innings is what Cole Belair gave the Rivets. Back-to-back nights now with six-inning starts. So Dahl, the right-handed freshman, will come on and face Fishbank, who flied out to right and grounded out to short, both in RBI opportunities against Belair. Kenosha 0-6 with runners in scoring position. As Fishbank pops the first pitch up to David Cronin, who's there to make the catch, one down. So one up, one down, here's Wes Weeks. He's done that, he's popped out to Cronin. And here he lines a ball out towards right. Corey Wright on the move, he makes a running catch. Two pitches, two outs. Weeks is 0-3. And here's Jack Yalowitz, and strike one will never be easier for Anthony Dahl because Yalowitz is likely taking no matter where the pitch is. You don't want a three-pitch inning. Yalowitz from the left side against his college teammate Belair went 0 for 2, a flyout to center and a strikeout swing. Yalowitz against Dahl. First pitch from the righty. Fastball, a strike 0-1. No action in the bullpen for Kenosha. Looks like Beltran is getting a second inning. A swing and a miss, 0-2. That last inning and that run, while he's on the hook for the loss, was not his fault. Two errors behind him. Here's the 0-2 from Dahl. A swing and a chopper down to Ramirez. He'll flip to Dahl, and it's a nice, easy 1-2-3 inning for the big right-hander. We go to the eighth. Rockford 1, Kenosha nothing.
After the nine-month grind of teaching the entire school year, those poor souls need a getaway. Well, fear not, because baseball is the answer. Join us Friday and Saturday night, June 10th and 11th at 6:35 for Teachers Appreciation Weekend at Rivet Stadium as Rockford hosts the defending Northwoods League champion Kenosha Kingfish for a two-game series. Get an infield reserve seat for the standard $10 and receive a complimentary drink, or purchase a standard price right field porch seat for $25 and get two complimentary drinks. Right field porch seats include all-you-can-eat hot dogs, brats, burgers, chips, soda, and water from the time gates open until 2 hours after first pitch. You can find nightly drink specials out on the right field porch as well. So make plans to join us June 10th and 11th for Teachers Appreciation Weekend at Rivet Stadium.
Back in Kenosha, BJ Walters with you. 1-0 Rivets as we go to the eighth inning. Join us for the first fireworks night of the year, Saturday at 6:35, when the Rivets face these same Kingfish. Enjoy a great night of baseball. Nick Camrata pitching will make sure of that. And cap it off with a spectacular fireworks show after the game. To get your tickets for fireworks night, go to rockfordrivets.com or call 815-240-4159. Josh Hauser will lead off the eighth inning. He is 0-2 with a walk. Two ground outs to short also in there. Looks like Zach Olszewski is up in the Rivets bullpen. Zach just getting to town today. First pitch, swing and a miss by Hauser, 0-1. He is the right-hander from Bethune-Cookman College, and now he's actually taking a seat. So he might not be coming in after all. This might be Anthony Dahl's game. 0-1 to Hauser. Beltran brings it. High a ball, 1-1. Second straight night that the Rivets have gotten quality pitching against these Kingfish. And when you're facing a defending champ, you better pitch the ball well. And they have. Here's the 1-1. A strike is called, 1-2. To be fair, Kenosha's pitched the ball just fine, thank you very much. 1-2 the count. Beltran gets his sign, stretches at the letters, and brings it home. Outside, 2-2. 2-2 the count. Beltran, left-handed. Comes set. And the Delray Beach, Florida native throws a slider swung on and missed by Hauser. One away in the eighth. Brings up Jacob Vanderwall, who's 0-3. Ground out to first, strikeout swinging. reached on a fielder's choice and was picked off back in the first. It's a 1-0 Rivets lead in the eighth. Beltran comes set, brings it home. High 1-0. A one ball count to Vanderwall. Some of the crowd took off with that rain shower. There's still lots of people here though. Not sure if we've seen an attendance figure or not yet. Not yet, I'm told. It will be a nice one for Kenosha tonight. The 1-0 is a strike, 1-1. One and one is the count. The stretch by Beltran after getting his sign, and the 1-1 to the redshirt freshman from Ohio State. Inside 2-1. A 2-ball, 1-strike count. Two and one. Beltran working in his second inning. Gave up the only run of the game to this point, although it was unearned. The 2-1. Outside, ball three. The Rivets have not drawn but the one walk tonight. That was Hauser leading off the game. Three and one the count. Vanderwall way ahead in the count. The stretch and the pitch. Swung on a little chopper that rolls foul, 2-3-2 rather. Three and two is the count. A payoff will be due to Vanderwall, the center fielder for the Rivets. 3-2, the stretch by Beltran, and the pitch. Swing and a miss, he struck him out. Three straight strikeouts for the left-hander. And with two down, here comes Alex Maloney. Two strikeouts and a ground out tonight. Here's Maloney from the right side. First pitch to Maloney is a fastball, strike 0-1. Beltran. Sounds like people have won jerseys off the backs. Is that what's going on? Yeah, wow, that's pretty cool. Here's the 0-1, it's high, 1-1. Of course, the Northwoods League creates a lot of major leaguers. If one of these Kingfish players were to make it to the bigs, that jersey would be worth a lot of money. 1-1 the count. Beltran stretches and brings it home. A swing and a high drive to left center field. Moving back on it to left fielder. That ball's gone! Alex Maloney, a line drive homer to left center. It's the first home run in Rivets history. And it's 2-0 Rockford. Alex Maloney got it. And he sent it over the Lee sign in left center. Two nothing, and here's Ricardo Ramirez. One and one the count. Go, go, go. Actually, no, this is Ramirez now, and he's taking ball one. Maloney with a rocket out of here, and it's 2-0. A run in the seventh, a run in the eighth. The attendance tonight, that is a good attendance number, 2,437 here at Simmons Field. The 1-1 is low. It's ball two. And Beltran is set and brings it home. Ball three. 3-0 to Ramirez. No action in either bullpen. The 3-0. Swing and a miss. Ramirez was trying to go back to back with Maloney. And it's 3-1. Three and one the count. And the 3-1. Swing and a miss, 3-2. Should Ramirez reach, Corey Wright would get an at bat here in the eighth. Three and two the count. By the way, the Rivets, the last team in the league to finally hit a home run. Here's a 3-2. Swung on, fouled straight back, still 3-2. And Alex Maloney is the answer to the trivia question 30 years from now, who hit the first Rivets home run. It's Alex Maloney. By then, he's got some gray hair. He's telling his grandkids about it. It's a cool moment. 3-2 the count. The stretch by Beltran in the pitch. Check swing, strike three called, and the inning's over. Beltran struck out the side, but Alex Maloney hit the first Rivets home run ever, and after 7.5, it's 2-0 Rockford.
Join us at Rivets Stadium June 24th for a 6:35 p.m. first pitch against Wisconsin Rapids. Get to the ballpark early to see a human cannonball enter the stadium during the pregame. It's also the first night of a four-night Cheap Trick bobblehead series. Check out the awesome bobbleheads and enjoy a night out at the ballpark by calling 815-240-4159 or visiting rockfordrivets.com for tickets today.
Join us for the first fireworks night of the year on Saturday night, June 11th at 6:35 when the Rivets face the defending NWL champion Kenosha Kingfish. Enjoy a great night of baseball and cap it off with a spectacular fireworks show after the game. To get your tickets for fireworks night, go to rockfordrivets.com or call 815-240-4159.
Make plans to join us at Rivets Stadium every Friday home game after that long week of work for TGIF night at Rivets Stadium. You can get $3 beer specials from the time gates open until first pitch is delivered. So kick back and enjoy some Rivets baseball with a cold beer in hand. Our next TGIF night is June 24th versus the Wisconsin Rapids Raptors. Call 815-240-4159 or visit rockfordrivets.com for tickets today.
We go to the last of the eighth. It's Anthony Dahl with now a 2-0 lead to protect against 9-1-2. Joe Swack, Hearn, and O'Brien. A run in the seventh unearned, a run in the eighth on the home run by Maloney. Looks like we're gonna escape the weather. They pushed the thunderstorm possibility back an hour. So we're probably looking at escaping the weather tonight. 9-1-2 in the order for the Kingfish. Cullen Joshua. There's going to be a pinch hitter. Marty Bacina in the eighth inning. From Michigan State, his first at bat of the year. He was just signed today and a strike from Dahl. Oh and one, the pitch, a slider, strike 0-2, and that's just not fair. I mean, mercy, that is not fair from Dahl. 0-2 and the pitch is low, 1-2. A ball and two strikes. The tall right-hander from Arkansas. Working here in the eighth. It's his second inning of work. Got to look at the scoreboard this inning. Dahl ready to bring home a 1-2. Grounded towards Maloney. He'll throw to first. One up, one down. Here comes Matt Hearn. 0 for 3, reached on an error and stole a bag back in the fifth. We mentioned about Mankato and Rochester. Last report had game one still going on, so we'll get a look and see if game two is yet underway. First pitch is low, a ball and no strikes. To the leadoff hitter, Matt Hearn. The 1-0 is grounded down to third. Bunnell throws across the diamond. And just like that, two away. Kean O'Brien will be the hitter. He's 1 for 3 with a single, reached on an error and grounded out to short. O'Brien from the right side looks at a strike from Dahl. It's 0-1. A 1 is low, and it's a ball and a strike. The pitch. Swing and a miss. It was 0-2, not 1-1. And the inning is over. A 1-2-3 inning. For Anthony Dahl, we go to the ninth. 2-0, Rockford.
Join us at Rivet Stadium June 24th for a 6:35 p.m. first pitch against Wisconsin Rapids. Get to the ballpark early to see a human cannonball enter the stadium during the pregame. It's also the first night of a four-night Cheap Trick bobblehead series. Check out the awesome bobbleheads and enjoy a night out of the ballpark by calling 815-240-4159 or visiting RockfordRivets.com for tickets today.
Join us Wednesday, June 29th at 11 a.m. as the Rivets take on the Madison Mallards for Kids Day at the ballpark. Your $10 ticket includes a voucher for a hot dog, soda, and a bag of chips. What better way to spend a sunny summer day than your child falling in love with the game of baseball? Enjoy Kids Day on June 29th out at the ballpark by calling 815-240-4159 or visiting RockfordRivets.com for tickets today.
Make plans to join us at Rivet Stadium every Thursday home game for Thirsty Thursday at 6:35. You can get $2 beer specials in the right field porch. So kick back and enjoy some baseball with a cold beer in hand. Our next Thirsty Thursday is June 23rd versus the Wisconsin Rapids Raptors. So call 815-240-4159 or visit RockfordRivets.com for tickets today.
Join us June 10th for Mystery Envelope Night at Rivet Stadium. The first 500 fans will receive a mystery envelope with the contents inside unknown until later in the game.
you could win one of several prizes, from tickets to cold, hard cash. You don't want to miss it. June 10th, 6:35 against Kenosha. Make plans to be at Rivet Stadium and get your prize.
We go to the ninth here in Kenosha. It's 2-0 Rivets. It'll be Corey Wright, Neil Tyrell, and Cade Bunnell against the left-hander in his third inning of work, Rigo Beltran. Beltran, left-handed pitcher against Wright, left-handed hitter. Corey Wright tried a drag bunt, and he fouled it off 0-1. Looking ahead to the last of the ninth against Dahl, Jadacki, Cannabis, and the dangerous Schuler will be due up for Kenosha. Lefty-lefty matchup here. Beltran ready, the pitch. Bends right in there, 0-2. Wright ducked out of the way, and it was a strike. And it's no balls and two strikes. Here comes the 0-2 in the dirt, 1-2. One and two the count. The stretch and the pitch from Beltran. Check swing in the dirt. And the count goes to 2-2.